Hello everyone. In this video, we will be covering a new topic for the chapter of kinematics of a particle, and we will resume our discussion about accelerated motion in this video, and we will go through uniformly accelerated motion. In our last video, we just started this topic and we introduced that a uniformly accelerated motion is a motion of a particle in which the acceleration is constant. So the acceleration acting on a particle is constant. And as we have defined, that acceleration is the rate at which the velocity is changing. So it means that the velocity is changing. Acceleration is a vector quantity and velocity is also a vector quantity. And whenever I am saying acceleration, so in general terminology, acceleration is referred to as like increase in velocity. So because acceleration is a vector quantity, so I cannot say that the magnitude of acceleration is such that the velocity is increasing, because it also depends on the direction. If the acceleration is in the same direction to that of velocity, then only the velocity will increase. And the negative acceleration, or the acceleration which is in the opposite direction to that of velocity, is known as deceleration. So deceleration leads to decrease in velocity, because the direction of the deceleration is opposite to the direction of the velocity. So just to give an example, if I am saying that my motion of the car is in plus x direction, and the car is moving towards the plus x direction, and it's a 1D motion, and if the acceleration is supporting this motion, and let's say the direction of the acceleration should be supporting the motion and should be in this direction, then I would say that okay, the acceleration is 5 m/s². Right? Just to give a number. And if my acceleration is opposite to that of the direction of the motion, so the acceleration would be here, then I can say that my acceleration is -5 m/s². So this minus sign indicates the nature of the opposite direction, which is opposing the motion of the particle. So here we are specifically discussing about uniformly accelerated motion. So in uniformly accelerated motion, throughout the time interval which we are considering, or throughout the motion of the particle, there is a constant acceleration acting on the particle. So first of all, we will just consider the 1D motion, because it will be easier to consider, and the equations which we will have for 1D motion are really useful, and we will be first dealing with 1D motion. So in 1D motion, if my particle is moving along this line, and this is plus x, and this is the initial position, and let's say the particle is at initial position at time t1, and this is the final position, and particle is at final position at time t2. The velocity of the particle at initial position is u, and the velocity of the particle at final position, let's say, is v. And I am not using the vector sign for any of those, because I am only considering 1D motion. So I will not be writing I cap or J cap associated with it, because even though it's not explicitly written there, but it's understood that it should be there, because I am only considering 1D motion. And just to write down that the definition, that this is the initial velocity and this is the final velocity. Now I can define the displacement. So displacement for this time interval of T2 minus T1 is final position minus initial position. And I'm writing the variable, I'm writing a variable S for this thing. And the particle is experiencing an acceleration A. And because A acceleration is constant, so it will be a single variable which will be acting on the particle throughout its motion from initial to the final position. So there are a set of three equations which are used again and again, and all the questions in this chapter will be using all those three equations, which are specifically used in case like this, which is a uniformly accelerated motion. So the first equation is V equal to U plus AT. So V is my final velocity, U is my initial velocity, A is the constant acceleration which is acting on the particle, and T is the time interval. And in this case, it would be T2 minus T1. And the velocity U would be the velocity at T1, V will be the velocity at T2. And you can see that this is a equation which is coming from the formula for the acceleration itself, because we know that the acceleration or the average acceleration, because acceleration is constant, is change in the velocity upon the time interval. So V minus U upon T2 minus T1 is V minus U upon T. So we'll just take T to the left hand side and U also on the left hand side, then we'll get this equation. So this is the basic first equation which we'll be using for uniformly accelerated motions. The second equation, so the point to note is that the first equation relates acceleration, time period and the velocities, but still we need an equation which should also use the displacement. So second equation is S is equal to UT plus half A T square. So S is the displacement here, and displacement is final minus initial position, U is the initial velocity, T again is the time interval which we are talking about, plus half into A is the constant acceleration which is acting, and T is the time interval again. So all the variables are the same which we have defined, and this is the equation which is relating the initial velocity, acceleration, time period and the displacement which has happened throughout in this time period. The third equation is S. So the third equation is written as V square equal to U square plus 2AS, or just 2A into S. So third equation does not have the term of time interval or T. It directly relates the acceleration, the constant acceleration A, displacement and initial and final velocities. And you can always like use multiple these three equations to get a new form of the equation, but these are the three basic fundamental equations which we will be using again and again to solve different questions. So let's say if I am just jumbling around, then I can easily get different forms of equations as well. Yeah. So these three equations, we'll not be going into the derivation of these equations right now, because they can either be derived through graphical method, they can also be derived by differentiation and integration. Till now, because we have not discussed the graphical method or differentiation or integration, so we'll not be going into the like explanation and
how do we derive, but it would be good to just remember all these equations, and we'll be using these again and again in different problem solving, which we'll do. Other than that, it's essential to note, which I earlier also mentioned, that because all these equations are applicable only to the one dimensional motion, that's why we have removed all the vector signs from velocities and accelerations and displacements, because all of them are vectors, and because we are considering 1D motion, so there should be an I cap or J cap associated with each and every of them, every variable of them, because all these are vector quantities. But we generally leave that sign because we know that it's a 1D motion and we do not need to apply those. But if we are moving into a 2D motion, then we should be applying all the equations only in one dimension separately. So let's say if I have a question in which a ball is moving in two dimension, then in along the x-axis I'll be using these three equations, where all the variables will all only be related to the x-axis, and similarly the same three set of equations will be used in the y-axis, where all the variables will come from the motion along the y-axis. And we'll go through all those questions in the later videos as well. First of all, we'll cover a couple of examples which will use these three equations, and it will make the concept clear to us.